I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Hello everyone. My name's Luke. I work with NZLC in Wellington. And today I'm going to show you various ways to say, I don't know. And the way you say, I don't know, has a slightly different meaning. For example, I don't know. I don't know. Now this is quite a normal and relaxed way to say it. I don't know. However, you can say it and sound annoyed. For example, I don't know. This shows someone is annoyed. I don't know. Another way to say it is to say it slowly. If you say, I don't know, slowly, you might be puzzled or curious about what the answer is yourself. For example, I don't know. I don't know. Now, other ways you can say I don't know. Here's another one I've prepared. I'm not sure. I'm not sure with the normal intonation. I'm not sure. Now this could also mean you may know a little bit about the subject. You can even add another word. I'm not so sure. You can even add a different word. I'm not entirely sure. I'm not entirely sure. This also may mean you know a little something about it. We have some more casual ways to say, I don't know. Something you would use with your friends. For example, I don't have a clue. Or, I don't have the foggiest. You might be wondering what this means, foggiest. Foggy is when there is water that comes up like a cloud from the sea and you cannot see through very well. So it's not clear. So hence, something is not clear. I don't have the foggiest. Two more casual examples I have for you. One of my favorite ones, who knows? Which actually means, I don't know. Again, this is casual, so just use it with your friend. Perhaps not in a speaking exam. Who knows? And last, a bit longer, your guess is as good as mine. Your guess is as good as mine. So many ways to say, I don't know. But the most important thing here is to use a variety of language when practicing. So when you learn something new in English, try to learn other ways to say the same thing and then practice, practice, practice. And then you will know.